Well, let's go back to the beginning. I met Jimmy Lyons in 1970 in Illinois, at the University of Illinois. And he said, would you like to work on the Monterey Jazz Festival? And I jumped at the chance. And I was there in the fall, September, and became part of the House Rhythm Section. Since it was a nonprofit organization, they decided that musical education would be the way to go.
When I started working here, I remember Jimmy Lyons always talking about the music part of it for the educational part with the students, and April was always his big, big baby.
And then I set about hiring some teachers, some clinicians who were also good players, to come up every 2 weeks. And we would make the rounds early in the morning teaching these kids about jazz.
And in 1981, Mundell hired me to lead the high school all-star band, which I have been doing ever since.
Of course, it's nice working with the kids here at the Monterey Festival. They've had a program for the young high school students for many years now. And these are the stars from all different places. Some of the guys in there from Sacramento, some from other cities. And they pick the best. And as you see, they play really great. It's a great program because it inspires them to work with someone who is actually in the business.
Well, the education program is actually the main thrust of the festival. Several very well-known people have come out of that program, and we have a high school all-star band from all over the West Coast that travels to Japan every year and plays at the festival. We have a county, Monterey County Honors Band, which also plays at the festival and tours either Europe or Australia. They've done both.
Students?
Yes, yeah. But Bill and Mundell did that so beautifully too. They didn't even leave me a little corner to help the kids. They had them all squared away. By the time I came to work with the kids, they had them very, very beautifully prepared.
All of us associated with the Monterey Festival are of those of you who have gone ahead and excelled.
That's right.
Yeah. We're really proud of them.
Keep your money and have your peace of mind. Oh,
is fine. Well, goodness do is fine now. You get to keep your money and save your peace of mind. Oh, wait a minute, baby. Wait a minute, baby. Hold it right there. Hey, hold it right there.
Back door crying. She
said, "Doc, you got home as long as I got mine. The lady ain't a jockey, but she taught me how to ride. Lady ain't a jockey, but she taught me how to come here, young man, listen. Get it once in the middle and then from side to side. And you can come back, baby, come back. Get back, baby, get back. Hurry back, darling. Come back, daddy. Well, now, come back, get it. Run one more time. One more time."
I'd like to do something here. The man that inspired me to sing the blues was a fellow named Joe Turner. And Joe Turner, he could also sing great love songs. Here's one of his great love songs we'd like to do for you right now, please. I was wondering, what in the world will I do in Brazil since I don't speak Portuguese? And the Brazilians settled that for me. They asked me for something that I had done and forgotten about, because Hank Jones played organ on this particular song that we recorded. But they sat back and looked at me and said, "Sing Imagination." I said, "What?" He said, "Sing Imagination." And I said,
Imagination is funny. It makes a cloudy day sunny, makes a bee think of honey, just as I think of you. Imagination is crazy. Your whole perspective gets hazy, starts you asking a daisy what to do. Have you ever felt a gentle touch and then a kiss and then find that it's only your imagination again? Imagination is silly. You go around willy-nilly, for example, I go around wanting that you want me to. Have you ever felt a gentle touch and then a kiss and then find it's only your imagination?